What is going on YouTube, one on the X-Room here. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome to today's video. We are going over the five things that I love about this right here, the Ducati V4S Streetfighter Dark Stealth. I know I did a five things I hate. That was actually a harder video than this one because there are way more than five things I love about this bike. But we'll go over the five things that I really enjoy and definitely love. Let's get into it. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Hit that subscribe button. If you like this video, give me a good thumbs up and then hit that little bell for notifications. Okay, so the first thing that I want to talk about that I love about the new 2021 Ducati V4S Streetfighter is the looks. It's a little controversial because honestly, at first, I didn't like the way it looked. It looked a little pointy, looked kind of weird, looked a little ridiculous because I'm so used to the Panigale and how that full fairing bike looked. So to come to this took a little bit of time, but the reason why I wasn't a huge fan of it at first was, if you look right here, to me, it looks like the profile shot of Mr. Burns. And then you come into these guys and they're so together. They look like a McBoyle twin. When you look at it, you might not like it right away, but as it sits in your mind and marinates and really you kind of look at all the angles, you look at the way the winglets and the front end look, it's great. It's mean looking, it's beautiful. And this freaking matte black, I love it. I've never been a huge fan of all red Ducatis. So to have one that isn't red at all, I love it. Now, the second thing I love about my Ducati Streetfighter is the power. I've already had the V4 Panigale Speciale, so I already knew what the V4 was about, but the way that the Streetfighter is tuned is a little bit different. The power down low is much more noticeable. It's got a good bit more oomph. So like cruising around town or just kind of getting out of turns, it's really nice. Now I know that the power doesn't kick you in the pants right as soon as you whack the throttle, but it's so usable and that's really what I like about it. If you want it to be more hardcore, yes, you can get a tune, but I don't want that tune. Obviously, when I get the exhaust, I'll do the Acropovic up map that comes with it, but I'm not gonna do the open box. I don't really wanna go that route, but I like how the power comes on. It's very smooth, not quite linear, you know, not in that sense that it's an inline four, but it's got that Ducati character. Honestly, it's kind of interesting at low idle. To me, it sounds like a V2. Like, I know that, okay, when it's idling, it cuts off two cylinders and it is a V2 in that sense. But the Panigale didn't sound like a V2. Even at low idle, this has that nice deep rumble that, you know, the twin had. The third thing, kind of going off the power and the fun part of it, is the ease of riding. This is probably the least intimidating and most easy Ducati that I've ever ridden, aside from a Diavel. That's, you know, that's a different story. But this bike, it's not intimidating. Like I said, the Panigales are all hardcore. They're always like, you gotta ring them out, you gotta run them. And that's the only language they understand. Whereas this bike understands that nice soft love language. It also understands that metal. It's one of the nicest Ducatis I've ever ridden as far as the ease and the rideability of it. You want to not get off of it. You want to just stay on it and keep riding it. I love that. All right, so the fourth thing that I absolutely love about my Ducati Streetfighter is the comfort. My God, is this the most comfortable Ducati that I have ever owned. I don't say it's the most comfortable I've ever ridden. I think the Multistrada is obviously more comfortable, but this style of motorcycle is insanely comfortable. I mean, look at this riding position. How can you not be comfortable like this? This is perfect for me. Like I said, I can't do the multis because my elbows drop and actually ends up putting a little pinch point on my elbow. So I need the bars to be down a little bit so my elbow doesn't drop below my hands. This is what it is right here. I mean, look how much leverage you have on. It's just so easy and so comfortable. I love how this bike feels. I don't want to get off of it, even though I just did, but when I'm riding it, I don't want to stop riding. And I'm like, okay, I'm just going to do the little track and come back. And I go, well, maybe I'll go a little further. And as my previous video mentioned, my limiting factor is obviously the fuel. But aside from that, I don't want to stop riding it. It's so good. Look at this seat. This seat is so squishy and soft. And it's got enough feel to where if you want to move around, you can. But then once you're there, it holds you really nice. So the fifth thing that I love about the Ducati is really an all-encompassing thing, and part of it's very subjective. It's a joy to ride. I love getting on it. I love looking at it. The whole experience of riding this Ducati, really makes you love the brand and love this bike. You know, like I said, the handlebars are wide, so you have a ton of leverage, so it makes it really easy. It's got a good perch to it, so you don't get fatigued. The brakes on it are fantastic. I mean, it's the same brakes that are on the Panigale, so you know that they're very strong and they have an amazing feel. The suspension, it's the electronic O-link, so like, it's super plush, or it can be stiffened up to where you can definitely get that feedback you need when you're trying to rip. I love the suspension package on it. I love the dash on it. Yes, again, it's just like the Panigale, so that's no surprise there, but it's super easy to read, easy to navigate the menus. We go back to the seat, it's super comfortable. Like I said, my fifth thing is really just the bike as an overall package. It feels like a very well put together machine that makes it a pleasure to ride, and the experience of it, you know, it's noticeable, it's different looking. So you feel special when you ride it, and that's kind of what I love about Ducatis is when you ride them, you feel a little something extra, not just the speed, not just the vibrations, but you have the aesthetics to go with it. And this bike just oozes with character. And I know people hate that, I say a bike has character, but this one absolutely does. You know, the way that everything works together, the throttle, I'm very surprised by the throttle with the Panigale. You know, when I rode the newer V4, I love that the slack is gone, that it doesn't have that weird quarter inch turn where nothing at all happens and then it just picks up like a bat out of the hell. This bike, just like the new V4 Panigale, doesn't have that throttle issue. It is on there all the time or it's off. One thing I actually really want to point out is the quick shifter. Ducati has always been that on or off type throttle to quick shifter ratio. Like, you either got to be completely out of it to shift or completely on it to shift. I've noticed that on this Streetfighter specifically, that I can be sort of off of it and still click through, or sort of on and still get through the gears. It doesn't get hung up and it doesn't fight itself. And that's something that I didn't really experience until I got with the Aprilias, where they are actually a good bit more forgiving. So I hope you guys enjoyed the five things that I love about my Ducati Streetfighter V4S Dark Stealth. Longest freaking name ever, aside from the CBR, but man, I enjoy the hell out of it. And that's really what I want you guys to get take from this. Is this is my first naked bike. It's my first upright riding bike. Everything else that I've had has been just hardcore super bike. And this really still checks those boxes of being just a monster and fast, but it also adds some fun. It adds a little less intimidation to it. It still has a drama I look for in a motorcycle, and I can ride it forever, again, aside from the gas mileage, but I love it. And if you guys are ever looking for a naked bike, there's a wide range out there. This is one that should absolutely be considered. So with that, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I love this thing and hope it shows in this smile. But with that, you guys have a good one. I'm out.